Welcome to the Black A History Channel. Please share this video and subscribe to this channel for more captivating content. The modern African continent's legislation has some of the strictest laws against LGBTQ people in the world, which, in my humble Black A African opinion, is only holding us back from becoming more unified and understanding of those that see us as other. What many African people either do not know or don't want to admit is that many ethnic groups in Africa prior to Arab and European influences had cultural norms that celebrated same-sex relationships, even marriages, that were sanctioned by the rest of the community. Here's a quick list of five African ethnic groups that celebrated same-sex relationships in African history. The Azande people. The Azande people are a Central African ethnic group that has a well-recorded history of embracing gay relationships and marriages between warriors prior to European colonization. The Azande are a large, expansive people, many of whom live primarily in the Central African Republic, Democratic Republic of Congo, and South Sudan. In their people's history, the Azande warriors had wives that lived in the village, but many also had male wives they would take on expeditions and battles when away from the village. The marriages between warriors were formal, and a bride price was paid to the younger warrior for the marriage, such as spears and livestock. The Zulu. The Zulu is another powerful and world-renowned ethnic group that also has a history of warriors who were allowed to have a husband or a boy wife on military expeditions. The name of these warrior boy wives was Izinkonshone, meaning warrior lovers, and there has also been speculation that the great King Shaka Zulu was gay. Some African historians, including Credo Mutwa, have mentioned the likelihood of the great Zulu king Shaka being gay or sexual with men. Shaka was a brutal warlord who had much respect from his people, yet he never had an heir or a queen, and he tortured many of his opponents by shoving a spear up. Well, use your imagination. The Zulu have many old words for gay affection between men, as well as many new modern Zulu terms that are used today. The Hausa people. The Hausa people is a large West African ethnic group, primarily based in northeast Nigeria, where the population is mostly Muslim. Prior to and during the Islamification of the era, the Hausa people had a society of gay, bisexual, and gender nonconforming men called the Yandawi that were known to be in discreet but permitted relationships with men, romantically or in order to make money. Many Yandawi men worked as food vendors, entertainers, or in sex work alongside women, but many also had wives and children of their own. The Yandawi still exists today, but because of Nigeria's modern anti-gay policies that ostracize gay men and LGBTQ people, the Yandawi, who were once respected as a part of Hausa culture, are less prominent in Hausa society today. The Ashanti are one of the most renowned West African ethnic groups, who are known for their stunning gold jewelry, kente cloth fabrics, and history of resilient battles during British colonization. However, many may not know that the powerful Ashanti people, who mostly reside in Ghana today, also used to permit men of royal classes to have male concubines. Some of the traditions that were noted by British historians during colonization was that some of the male concubines were dressed as women, but their roles as sexual and romantic companions of royal figures was made quite clear. The royal system of the Ashanti people is vast, so it's likely that if there were male concubines for the royals, then that also means these weren't the only same-sex relationships in their history. The Berbers. The Berbers are a North African ethnic group that reside across most of the countries in modern-day North Africa, including Egypt, Morocco, and Algiers. The Berbers have some of the best recorded histories of socially accepted gay relationships amongst African ethnic groups, with vast amounts of sociologists, historians, and Berber folklore reporting villages and cities of Berber men that openly celebrated romantic and sexual relationships between them. The Siwa oasis in southern Egypt was particularly noted by historians to be a village that celebrated gay unions, including lavish gay weddings and an entire culture that promoted gay romance. Many historians of the late 19th century and early 20th century noted that the Siwa oasis was so gay that male brides were more expensive and more fought over than the women brides.